Although recent developments seem to have breathed new life into the Attiak sugar factory, with 50% of the total orders of machinery needed to boost productivity received so far, the proprietors still feel frustrated by slow decision-making of Uganda Development Corporation, the investment partner, and the continuous infamous statements from politicians. After setbacks caused by the fires that ravaged the canes and the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic, the factory is set to resume operations in 2024. The company's director, Planning and Development, says new strategies have been developed to tackle the back and forth delays.
We received the funds. We are given so many procedures that this was not done, this was not done. So we also don't need to be part. So what we've agreed is to work on a hybrid. And the hybrid is very simple. We give you the list of items. We go through it together. We make sure you go through your processes of verifying the cost, the activities of this. No procurement would be done. It is purchased directly. Share certificates would be given. And then from the revenues of the organization, it would be recovered. So I think that will resolve these challenges going forward.
Everybody has politicized Attiak Sugar Factory. We need to understand where we come from. And we agree where we came from. And also, you guys need to understand the dynamic when our chair for the board was coming to this part of the region. I grew up from this region. I know how this region can be tough in terms of entry into investment.
The facility is looking to maintain its capacity production, where at least 1,650 tons of raw sugarcane will be crushed daily. To manage costs and make returns on investment, Attiak factory will mainly supply the northern part of the country and parts of South Sudan.
Once the project gets to full development, we will rarely see our products being in Kampala. It makes more logical sense for me to work in the sub-region that I'm in. Because for them to bring sugarcane from Kakira all the way to Gulu, to Arua, to Nebi, to Kabiramaido, I am closer. The transportation cost of mine is lower.
Inaugurated by President Yoweri Museveni in 2020 in the northern district of Amuru, the factory was forced to suspend operations due to dual onslaught of wildfires and unrelenting COVID-19 pandemic effects.